Hello everyone, welcome to new Vue.js tutorial. Today we are going to take the help of this API, that is at api.adviceslip.com, and we are going to make a search feature. So basically we are going to search advice using this simple API. So we will put an input query from the user and we will be searching the advice using the same. So let's see how we can do that. So we are going to create a searching advice feature, and we'll going to take a dynamic input, and we are going to then render the data using the list group of the Bootstrap, and we will see how we can do that. And we are going to fetch a very dynamic data, so we don't know how much data we are going to get, and we are going to render the same. So for that, I've already made the boilerplate index.html and index.js. So for this, what we can do, we can create a div class is equal to call md6. Just for the responsive part, I'm doing this. And then inside this, what you can put style is equal to margin 1 rem auto. Okay, you can give a padding of 1 rem, and for the same, this is perfectly fine. And what we can do, you can give a class text center. Okay, you can remove this as now, and then you can give a feature h1, you can give a search advice. Okay, so this looks perfectly fine, and for this you can give style is equal to text align center, and you can give a margin 0 auto. Okay, so you can also give a 1 rem auto for that. Okay, and when we refresh this page on R, so we get a search advice at the center, and there is already a container which we can see. Okay, if you want to see the container, you can give a border. You can give a border 1 rem solid, okay, and black. I hope this is a shorthand property, and this would make you show the, like, this is very too much. The 1 rem is too much. You can give like 1 pixel is perfectly fine instead of rem. Okay, now let's refresh this page. So here you see the search advice. Okay, in the same way, what we are going to do, we are going to give input type is equal to search. Okay, so input type is equal to search, and we are going to give a class is equal to form control. And in another way, we are going to another input, that is input type is equal to submit, and for this we are going to give a class of button primary. We are going to give class is equal to button primary. And what we are going to do, style, we are going to give a style of display block, and then we are going to give a margin of 1 rem on auto. Okay, so this is perfectly fine, and we had to put all this input type inside a form. Okay, so now we have already put this inside the form, so this is perfectly fine. We have to put this inside the form, and what we need to do, we had to put this inside a form, and then we have to make a tab, and then we have to do @submit.prevent is equal to get data. Okay, and when we make we'll make a method which says, inside our methods we are going to build a get data which is going to be async, because we'll wait for the API response, async get data. And for that, what we can do, okay, console.log this.query. okay, but we haven't made the query, and for this query is going to be null. Perfectly fine, we are going in the right direction. And in this, we need to vmodel to the query at the component. So I hope you all are getting this, because you would be pretty much efficient. So let's remake thing, and let me type hello. Okay, we have an error at line number 7. Okay, let me see index.js line number 7. Okay, so this is methods. Okay, yeah, so we are going perfectly fine, async So let me refresh this page. So let me, I have error, let me check. Okay, the error was that I had basically missed a curly brace tag here. So I had missed that. I'll show you, I'll highlight where I had missed. I had made a miss because this was the curly tag for the JSON object for the return statement, and this was the curly braces for the data. Now let me save and refresh. So it's perfectly fine, and I'll type live. So here you see I have the response live at the back end. So like not so at the component has the data. So now what I want to do, I'll make an empty JSON array using data. Okay, and this is a empty JSON array. So now what I'll do await axios dot get. Okay, so when I get this, okay, I'll get this, I'll make two things. One is the dot then part, okay, and another is the dot catch part. So inside the catch part, I'll simply do error, and I'll do console dot log error. Okay, and in this then part, I'll do response. I'll get the response. Okay, response, and I'll do this dot data is equal to response dot data. And one thing I need to mention here, when I move to this, and I'll get, so the slips is the JSON array we are getting. So we'll do response dot data dot slips. Okay, and then what I can do, I do console dot log this dot data. Okay, so let me refresh. And oh, I forgot to hit the API. So for how to hit the API, you can do copy this, and you can, or you can copy this. You can copy this and you can put it here, but I'll show you one thing how you do put it. So for this you need to, okay, so here you can see the query has to be this. So what I need to do, I need to define a curly symbol here, and should be this dot query, very simple. Okay, so let me refresh and let me put live. So here you can see I have a JSON array. Okay, so it says a data. So this is how we get the data inside the JSON array. Okay, so what I can do inside my HTML page, what I can do, I can simply print this data. Okay, let's try one more thing once again how we get the data, but it's going to be very unformatted. Let's refresh. Here you can see the empty JSON array. I hope it's perfectly fine. Okay, I'll do one thing. Okay, then let me put live, and here you can see we get a very unformatted data. This data is very much same we are getting here. Okay, but this data, unformatted data, is of or no use if you don't format it. So what we can do, I'll use list group of Bootstrap. So I'll copy this UL class is equal to list group, and inside my HTML I'll put it here, and I'll have only list item, and I'll do a V for loop. Okay, and for that I'm going to do item in I'll do item comma index in data. So data what we are getting, and I'll print two things. Index starts from 0, so I'll do index plus 1. Okay, I'll put a dot then item. Okay, and I'll do item, and make sure, because we had do item dot id or slips. So what do you want? So we want the advice, so we'll do item dot advice. Okay, so this is perfectly fine. Let me close the page and refresh this live. Perfectly fine. We don't need this unformatted data. So what we can do, this is perfectly fine. Let's refresh and do once again. Let's refresh and we say live, we get the data in a formatted way. So this is how we do it, and this is how we get the dynamic data, and this is how we render in the Vue.js. So thank you everyone for watching this tutorial. I hope this is very clear. Then you can remove this console.log statement, it's not needed, and this is how we render the data on the front end. So thank you everyone for watching this tutorial. So thank you everyone.